Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to UrbanForex.com. Here's another psychological audio that I've prepared for you guys. There's nothing going to be on the video screen, this is simply just audio. On this audio, I'm going to be discussing what's the reason behind confidence and trust. So this one's based on confidence and trust. Now, one thing for sure is, you know, when you pick a strategy, any strategy that you pick, you're trading, you make a profit, keep going, profit, 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 you make one loss, you make two losses, three losses. What is the probability that you're going to switch that strategy? Pretty high, huh? See, this is the reason why. When you go between switching strategies, like within 6 months, if you're switching strategies multiple times within a matter of 6 months, that means all that thought process that you put into picking that strategy, you just threw it away within a matter of seconds. I mean, think about it. What made you pick the strategy first of all? It was good, it was profitable, then why doubt it? Stick to your strategy. Almost all strategies work in the market. Things that we're not loyal to them, you have to stick to them and be loyal to them. They will work. Now, if they've worked before and you've back tested them yourself manually, it doesn't just change on you overnight. Now, that's another thing. Another thing is that when you pick a strategy, you have to make sure that the probability of winnings to losings is a little bit higher. Here, let me tell you the reason why for that. Because everybody says that if you have a 1-to-1 ratio, which means if you have a 20 pip stop loss and you 20 pip take profit, and you're winning 51% of the time, that's a good strategy. Yeah, I agree, that's a good strategy. You'll end up with positive money in your bank at the end of the day, but what does that do? That messes with your confidence. Now think about it this way. If you have 20 trades, and from 20, 15 if not 18 trades are in your favor, it worked, wouldn't you have confidence? Wouldn't you have like inner confidence that I can do this? And if you're doing like 20 trades, and from the 20 trades maybe 10 or 11 go successful and the rest 9 or 10 go unsuccessful, wouldn't that mess with your mind? Be like, it'll make you start questioning yourself, like, did I pick the right strategy? Am I doing the right thing? So it's really important to pick the strategy that has a good probability success rate, as well as it's important to trust in the strategy, because if you've picked the strategy, there's a reason why you picked it. Stick to it. Don't abandon it. Stick to it. Work on it. Additional things that you have to keep in mind is your time. Try not to give your charts too much time. If you have 24 hours in a day, don't give 20 of it to your charts. Do something else. Give like 2 or 3 hours a day to your charts. Have an alert system. Have somebody call you. Join a chat room. Join a signal service or something. But don't sit in front of the charts, because the way the market moves is gonna make you wanna trade. It's gonna make you think that it's gonna do something. It's psychological. Don't fall into that category. We're gonna be baits if we do that. So, you know, if you place a trade, you have your stop loss, you have your limits, you know, go take your wife out to dinner or take your husband out to dinner. Do whatever you wanna do, but don't sit in front of that PC once you're in. So all I'm saying is that focus, but don't over focus, because then it'll get you to over trade. So be very careful. Okay, so that pretty much concludes confidence and trust in yourself and in your system for this audio session. Thanks for tuning in.